Illinois Wesleyan University is making its second trip to the finals and the first in 9 years since coming to the Fox Cities in 2001. The Titans earned a spot in the finals with an impressive run through the field at the Moline, Illinois Regional. Illinois Wesleyan went 4-0 at the regional and capped the tournament with a 10-3 victory over Buena Vista University in the title game. Craig Ladd went 4-for-4 to lead the Titans in the title game, and Brent Moore and Kevin Sullivan had three hits apiece. Illinois Wesleyan scored two times in the first and three more times in the third before Buena Vista got on the board. The Titans were up 6-1 and pulled away with four runs in the fifth. That was all the offensive starting pitcher Paul Cavs would need. He went seven innings, allowing six hits, struck out four, and walked one to earn the victory. Illinois Wesleyan finished fourth in the College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin, which won the conference tournament to earn a berth to the NCAA Division III tournament. The Titans, who have won seven consecutive games, are now 27-20 on the season. Senior Casey McIntosh leads the Titans with a .357 batting average. He has smacked a team-high 11 home runs and driven in a team-best 54 runs. Senior Mike Morrissey is hitting a solid .324 and is second on the team with 39 runs batted in. Other key players for the Titans are senior Brett Moore, who is hitting .289 with 20 RBIs, and senior Craig Ladd, who is hitting .245 with 35 RBIs. The pitching staff is led by Jason Pancock, a junior, who has put together a 9-2 record with a 2.67 earned run average. Pancock has struck out 80 and walked only 18. Senior Brent Kulovic is second on the team with five victories and has a 5.23 earned run average. Kulovic has struck out a team-high 81 in only 75 innings. Calling the shots from the dugout is head coach Dennis Martle, who is in his 23rd season at Illinois Wesleyan. Martle, a 1984 graduate of the University of Maine, has compiled a record of 591 wins, 367 losses, and three ties. His teams have won six College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin championships. Founded in 1850, Illinois Wesleyan University is a private, highly selective, liberal arts university located in Bloomington, Illinois, about 135 miles southwest of Chicago. With an enrollment of just over 2,000 undergraduates from 34 states and 22 countries, Illinois Wesleyan's distinctive liberal arts curriculum is at the core of its 50 majors and programs.
In Friday's final game, Illinois Wesleyan got on the scoreboard with a pair of two-run home runs in the first inning. Casey McIntosh got things started with his blast to left center field, and Jeff Gradecki followed suit two batters later to make it 4-0. After Shenandoah cut its deficit to 5-4, Illinois Wesleyan tallied runs in both the sixth and seventh innings to pull away. The Titans made the score 6-4 on a sacrifice fly by McIntosh and 7-4 on Mark McDermott's run-scoring single. The Hornets added one run in the ninth inning and had the game-tying run at the plate, but the Titans' Jason Panko was able to get Scott Van Dusseldorf to ground out to third base to go the distance and end the Shenandoah threat. Panko finished the contest with seven strikeouts while picking up his 10th win of the season. Our eighth game of the tournament features the Berg of Heidelberg University and the Titans of Illinois Wesleyan University. Illinois Wesleyan improved to 28-20 on the season with last night's 7-5 win over Shenandoah University. It was the eighth straight win for the Titans. Our 11th game of the tournament is a battle of the last two unbeaten teams as the Wildcats of Linfield College square off against the Titans of Illinois Wesleyan University. Illinois Wesleyan snapped Heidelberg's 18-game winning streak with a 4-3 victory on Saturday night. The Titans rallied from a 3-2 deficit with single runs in the 7th and 8th innings and improved to 29-20 on the season. The College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin member pushed its own winning streak to 9 games. The Student Princes went ahead 2-0 before Illinois Wesleyan scored a pair of runs in the top of the 5th inning. Brett Moore picked up a run-scoring single in the inning for the Titans. Heidelberg took the lead back in the bottom of the 5th when Alvin Williams belted a run-scoring double for a 3-2 edge. Illinois Wesleyan tied it at 3-3 in the 7th inning when Craig Ladd doubled and scored on Mike Morrissey's single. The Titans then took a 4-3 lead in the 8th when Jeff Gradecki doubled and Zach Scott followed with a run-scoring triple. Gradecki went 2-for-4 and scored a pair of runs for the Titans. With a position in Tuesday's title game already clinched, Illinois Wesleyan University looks to remain undefeated in this year's tournament when it battles State University of New York, Cortland. Winners of 10 straight games, Illinois Wesleyan brings a 30-20 record into today's game after edging Linfield College 4-3 on Sunday night. The Titans opened the tournament with wins of 7-5 over Shenandoah University and 4-3 over Heidelberg University. Illinois Wesleyan rallied from a two-run deficit with three runs in the bottom of the seventh inning in its win over Linfield. Mike McDermott drove in the Titans' first run with a run-scoring single in the second inning, but Linfield took a 3-1 advantage on Kelson Brown's solo home run in the sixth inning. In the Titans' seventh, Ryan Hopp and Jeff Kredecki each drove in runs before Zach Scott singled home the go-ahead run. Joe Frelick worked seven innings of relief for the victory and scattered seven hits while allowing just one run. Frelick induced an inning-ending double play in the eighth and set the Wildcats down in order in the ninth. Welcome to the 2010 NCAA Division III Baseball National Championship. Illinois Wesleyan makes its first appearance in the national title game and enters the contest with a record of 30-21. The Titans suffered their first setback of the tournament on Monday with an 11-10 loss to State University of New York, Cortland. Illinois Wesleyan opened with a three-run first inning initiated by a leadoff triple by Brett Moore. Cortland matched the Titans' run total with three runs in the bottom half of the inning. Illinois Wesleyan's Craig Ladd then homered to left field to lead off the second frame as the Titans regained the lead 4-3. Illinois Wesleyan trailed 7-4 going into the sixth. Casey McIntosh got one run back with a sacrifice fly. The Titans then knotted the score at 7-7 when Moore scored on a bases-loaded walk followed by an RBI single by Jeff Kredecki. Cortland tacked on three more runs over the next two frames to lead 10-7. That the Titans would keep chipping away. Kevin Sullivan scored on a ground out and Ryan Hopp touched home on a throwing error to make it 10-9. Illinois Wesleyan tied it in the top of the ninth inning. Moore led off with a single and later scored on Sullivan's double to left center field. Cortland avoided extra innings when Sean Bailey doubled home the winning run in the bottom of the ninth inning. The Titans pounded out 15 hits in the contest, led by three hits apiece by Moore, Gradecki, and Mark McDermott.
From Fox City Stadium in Grand Chute, Wisconsin, this is the 2010 NCAA Division III Baseball Championship. This afternoon, it's all on the line for all the marbles. The Titans from Illinois Wesleyan taking on the Red Dragons from SUNY Cortland State. Hi again, everybody. Bob Brainerd along with Bill Brophy, and we'll be joined by Sophia Minner. Well, Bill, the theme for these two teams playing for the national championship, it would be the first for either one that pulls it off, besides the Christmas color uniforms out there, it's been survival and finding ways to win, especially in the postseason. Both these teams have had to survive some very unusual circumstances, but both teams have found ways to win.
Well, who'd ever think, if you're an Illinois Wesleyan fan, on April 29th, you'd be playing for the national championship on June 1st. They were 14-17 at the time, but they've had timely hitting, got good pitching, and played awfully good defense. They were the last unbeaten team in this tournament until last night when Cortland State beat them 10-9. That capped the unusual route for Cortland. After they lost 25-11 Saturday, they have been survivors, and they've clubbed their way to the title game. Earlier today, they beat Linfield 12-9. They have scored 66 runs in five games. They can bang the ball. They're led by Anderson Gardner, who in this tournament is 10-16 with four home runs. He's driven in 14 and scored 14 runs. So he's hitting the ball. He's white hot. He'll try to back the pitching of Mike Aspen today. He'll go against the Illinois Wesleyan ace, Jason Pankow.
No more double elimination. One game only. The winner is crowned the national champion. 3-2. Deep to left center. Going back, looking up, off the scoreboard. Jeff Kredecki hit his own face.
That's a poke for Kredecki, who's had quite the tournament. Second blast of the tournament for Kredecki, who's now 9-16 with two homers and six RBIs in the D3 championship. Wow. That was a bomb.
In fact, Illinois Wesleyan coming in to the tournament, one of the final eight teams, they weren't ranked in any poll. Coaches poll, D3.com baseball pool, nothing. But here they are. And there goes Domino back to the dugout. Caught looking. Third punch out for Pankow.
Who seems to be more comfortable on the mound? Let's see how he is against the best hitter in the tournament. And arguably, I don't think even arguably, Anderson Gardner is the most outstanding player in this tournament.
No argument from me. I think we could go around the yard here and take a poll and get the same result. 0-1 to Anderson. And he hit that rocket to right, but Sullivan got underneath it, had it, and it glanced off his glove. It kept the inning alive.
Gardner was 4-for-4 against his club last, 3-for-4 last night with 4 RBIs and 4 runs scored. He was 2-for-4 earlier today against Linfield with 4 RBIs and 1 run scored.
Anderson, a senior. 1-2, fouls it off. He's a catcher, he's DH'd some to rest him, but to keep his bat in the lineup. Nickel, who had the two-run jack, waits on deck. 1-2 on the way. Swing and a miss. Back-to-back K's here in the third for Pankow.
He was caught looking against Linfield to prove he was human. There he swings through him.
Two up, two down.
Pankow making a statement against the middle of the Cortland lineup.
And here is Steve Nickel. He was trying to deposit one even further than his first inning shot.
He is 13-for-23 in the tournament with 2 homers and 11 RBIs. Make it 14 RBIs. As I say, in a normal year, we'd be throwing superlatives at Nickel. He's kind of an oh by the way,
sure,
because of what Gardner has done hitting ahead of him in the lineup. But he has had a superlative national championship.
0-2. Pankow showing no fear here in the third.
Nope, going right after the heart of the lineup.
Looking to strike out the side. And he does. That was a momentum boost for the guys in green. They got a run back in the second. Strike out the side, the third. Bottom three on tap, 2-1 our score. Mike Morrissey waiting for the 0-2. Bounce to the first. The out at first, the throw home, not in time. Got to the plate, Gardner.
But the first baseman tagged the bag, taking the force
right
off.
Yep.
The catcher was unaware of that. He's still arguing that he tagged the plate and did so, beating the runner. But because the first baseman tagged the bag, the force was off and the catcher had to tag him. He never did tag him. He did tag the plate and the throw did beat the runner. But when Zielnicki tagged the bag, the force came off. So we have a tie game.
To the gap, right center. And nope, no catch by Domino. 2 runs in, Sullivan gets the stop sign. Thought about it inside the park there for a moment, but they won't get greedy. The Titans do, however, have the lead. Domino almost made a sensational catch to end the inning.
He goes a long way here. You see, stretches out and just misses it. Ball goes all the way to the fence in front of the American sign. Sullivan pouring it on, as you said. He thought about going for all four, but they wisely hold him up at third. He has a tie-breaking 2-run triple.
Someone's going home at the hardware for the first time. First pitch, deep to center. Domino, back. Gone! Domino again with a great effort. But Grodecki again with a home run.
Second of the day, third of the tournament. Wow. National championship here on that Jeff Gradecki. Hit that one to the deepest part of the ballpark, about 400 feet. That may be all for Aspen. Joe Brown to the mound, Gradecki to the dugout to receive lots of plaudits.
Brown a peek back at the runner. Ladd, who's covering first? Nobody. They're gonna send the runner home because the ball goes all the way into right. Oh my goodness. 6-2 Illinois Wesleyan. That's why I pointed out they have been in games aplenty like this before. Little looper to left, base hit. Another run in. 7-2. But the momentum shift certainly going the way of Illinois Wesleyan at the moment.
Yeah, it's palpable. Nice piece of hitting by Morrissey there. He goes the other way, serves that one into left field in front of Simone.
Ladd at third, Morrissey at second, Sullivan at first. 0-2 on the way to Hop. Bounced up there, getting away. Here comes Ladd. Another run in.
The Red Heart Gardner on deck. You know, Pank, I like to get Domino here. In fact, he'd love a double play ball.
To Scott, second for one, relay, in time! Ask and ye shall receive. DP ends the inning. To the gap, left center, no one will get it. Bounces off the wall. Grodecki is in. McDermott, throw to the plate. Not in time. Two more on the board for the Titans.
McDermott never stopped running. Got a great read on that ball. Again, Domino's got such speed and such a good defensive outfielder. I think a lot of us thought he might get closer to it than he did. McDermott wasn't one of those. He was off at the crack of the bat and scored all the way from first. June kind of hesitated on the relay throw. Might have cost him, but it's 10-2 for Illinois Wesleyan, and there's Joe Brown to the mound. This may be all for Brown.
Deep to left center. Gone. Not quite anymore. Made a lot of noise with a three-run jack.
That is the 13th homer of the year for Casey McIntosh. He now has 61 RBIs. That one cleared the 385 mark to the right of the scoreboard with lots to spare. And the party continues for all those folks from Illinois Wesleyan that made the trip. There you can see it flew over the 385 mark. And the Titans are having some fun. They hardly look like the underdogs anymore.
By design, they wanted him to face Gardner and then make the switch.
And he will lead to a standing ovation from the folks, maybe the whole place. I think everybody recognized he cooled off an awfully hot hitting team. And everybody rises as one, and Pankow's happy to acknowledge the cheers.
Yeah, say what you will about the huge numbers on the scoreboard, but his outing just as important and just as clutch as the offense in this title game. Top of seven, 17-2 our score. Sophia Minert with another story to tell.
Guys, these Titans, I think when they're not on the baseball field, they're out shopping. If you look in the dugout, you'll see freshman pitcher Nick Men wearing a pink Disney princess backpack. Now, this started when senior pitcher Paul Capps decided to do a rookie initiation just like in the major leagues. He went to Walmart, bought the Disney backpack, and gave it to freshman pitcher Nick Men. He's now had the duties of carrying the backpack to every game. Nick stocks the backpack each game with sunflower seeds and snacks for guys in the bullpen. And I think, guys, 9 outs away, they're ready to put some medals in that backpack. And, guys, I know you're wondering, Cinderella is featured on that backpack. How appropriate, right?
Two outs, Jason Simone will step in.
Dennis Martel apparently got a sense of humor too. Went to the University of Maine, so like everybody in New England, big Boston fan. When he went out to exchange the lineup cards with Scott Barocious, the infield coach, when they played, he put on the lineup card, "Go Red Sox Nation." Barocious, the former Yankee lad.
Well, today it's Go Titans. Three outs away from a national championship, their first ever. Bottom of eight, 17-3, guys in green. Those guys on the front step of the dugout, they keep taking one step forward, one step back. 2-2. Laced, grabbed, ball game. And in Bloomington, Illinois, the fans will indeed remember the Titans.
There's your championship dog pile. And what a run it's been for an Illinois Wesleyan team which was 500 on April 29th. A 20-loss team wins a national championship on June 1st.
They couldn't wait to get their hands on the trophy. They've already got it.
Fourth in their conference, sixth seed in the region, number one in the country on June 1st.
They'll be celebrating all the way back to Bloomington. That'll be some bus trip. And what a trip it was.
They outslugged the Sluggers, banging out 18 hits, breaking the game open with a 9-run fifth inning, and the hero today was Gradecki, who went 5-for-5 with 2 home runs, 3 RBIs. He scored 4 runs. And for the tournament, Gradecki went 13-for-20 with 3 home runs and 8 RBIs.
Sophia Minert, she's down in the field with a couple of guys in green.
All right, here with the winning pitcher, Jason Pankow, Jeff Gradecki. Jason, 7 1/3 innings pitched, just 1 earned run, 6 hits, 9 strikeouts. A dominant performance. You get the hottest hitting team. What was your approach today on the mound?
You know, I was just kind of hoping to hold them. You know, I knew we were going to score a run, so I was kind of hoping I'd keep them down, especially after that first inning. Just want to make sure I kept it, make sure they didn't score, basically.
You win 2 games this tournament. You now tie the school record for most wins in a season. How does it feel to do it in a national championship game?
It's awesome. I can't even describe it. I mean, they got me there. They gave me the opportunity for it, so it's amazing.
One guy who made your job a little easier today is this guy right here next to you, Jeff Gradecki. 5-for-5, 2 home runs, 4 runs for you today. Would you ever think you'd have that line in a national championship game?
Never. I was feeling it today. The ball seemed like a beach ball out there. Just wound back, struck it hard all day.
It seemed like in April, your season was almost over. You were not even 500. You were just hoping to make it to the conference tournament. How does it feel to wrap up the season like this?
You can't do it any better way. You really can't.
It's unbelievable.
All right, guys, congratulations, Division III baseball champs.
Thank you so much.
Sophia, thanks. Those guys are speechless, and you can't blame them. What a story. What a Cinderella story. Monkey, backpack, they did it all.
They both get named the all-tournament team, which also includes Kelson Brown of infield, Kyle Domino of Cortland, Rhett Fenton of infield, Anderson Gardner, and Matt June of Cortland. Not surprisingly, Gradecki is on there. So is Casey McIntosh and Mark McDermott, along with Pankow, Steve Nichol of Cortland, and Jeremy Richter of Stevens Point. The most outstanding player is Jeff Gradecki.
How fitting. And to the winner go the spoils.
That's what they played for.
Yep.
Hats off to Cortland State. I mean, they did it the hard way. There's the monkey on the championship trophy. Never seen that before, but you'll see it in Bloomington, and they'll wear that proudly. But Cortland did it the hard way. They didn't get much pitching, but they outslugged their opponents till they ran into the guys in green, the improbable champs from Illinois Wesleyan. But finally, Pitching always triumphs, good hitting, doesn't it? Hank out proved that to us today. He was good when he had to be. His teammates picked him up with an 18-hit attack. It will be a tournament that was remembered for hitting, and it will be remembered in Bloomington, Illinois forever.